My name is Adam Bachstetter. I'm an assistant professor in the Spinal Cord and Brain Injury Research Center at the University of Kentucky, and I run my own lab, so it's the Bachstetter Lab. My dad was a carpenter. There wasn't really anybody in my family who were a scientist or doctor, so I didn't really have a lot of influence of any role models that I could think of. So science wasn't something that was actually in my original plan. As a kid, I actually wanted to go into the FBI. I was really still am obsessed with, you know, TV law shows, and I think the FBI was something that I thought would be really fun to do. And I was really into mixed martial arts at the time, so I thought that, oh, this is a way I can, you know, use my skills. And I went to college in Columbus, Ohio at Capital University. It's a small liberal arts college. As an undergrad, I was in a psychology program because I was pre-law, and I went to work in a neuroscience lab as an internship. And it was just that was the experience that sort of, you know, sparked my interest. And I was studying neurons and looking at really one of the classic ways to look at neurons, which is the Golgi stain, which is how the neuronal doctrine was really established. And just being able to see the neurons and just looking at them was just such a beautiful experience. And it kind of really just got me excited about it. And that was the end. And then I did my graduate work at the University of South Florida. And then I started my postdoctoral work at Northwestern University. And then moved here to University of Kentucky and finished some postdoctoral work. Being my own PI, it's really great being able to mentor students and working and interacting with the team and being able to have them interact with other colleagues that I have and kind of teach them new techniques and allow them to explore and grow as a scientist themselves, which is really what I'm here for more, is to really help them grow. I'm still at the beginning stages of my career, so I'm lucky that I'm able to both get into the lab a little bit more than maybe I'll be able to later. A lot of days are spent writing and reviewing papers and kind of directing my postdoc and other members of the lab and helping them design their experiments. It's more of I'm here to help facilitate them to design how they're going to conduct their experiments and kind of teach them how those experiments should run. The most challenging aspect of research is when you really been working on an idea for a while and you have a strong feeling that it will work, but you just can't figure out what is the step that is making it not. And you just, so it's the most challenging and also the most exciting. You saw my postdoc came in today and she's like, aha, it finally worked today. And that's what, it's really exciting. We're really interested in how cells other than the neurons, so the glial cells and this immune cell called the microglia, interact with neurons to contribute to the development of diseases, particularly age-related diseases like Alzheimer's disease. And we're working on how traumatic brain injury might alter those cells in some way, either damage the cell or cause a recruitment in the case of the microglia or macrophage to the brain, and that those cells may contribute to the development of disease progression for Alzheimer's disease or make it so that you're at a greater risk for developing Alzheimer's disease or other age-related neurodegenerative diseases. So we're focused on traumatic brain injury and Alzheimer's disease. In our small instance, it could go wider for other neuroscience, but techniques that we're developing could be used in other fields, could be used in non-academic, non-science. Even though we're looking in the brain, this could have a much wider aspect. I think the future of our science is we're at the very early stages of understanding how glial cells become dysfunctional, what makes them not healthy. And if we can figure out what are the processes, what are the signaling, what's the biochemistry of this, then we can start to develop ways to modify or target those processes to develop drugs that could potentially treat people who've had a traumatic brain injury or people who are at risk for developing a neurodegenerative disease like Alzheimer's disease. UK's environment is just incredibly collaborative. It's just a great place to work. So many colleagues are always helping each other and working together. And having that support and that team and that environment, just everybody being family, just makes it a great place to be and very productive place to be.